Dirty Deely, it's the oldest and the dirtiest coal plant in CPS's Energy's fleet.
We continue our coverage on the CPS Energy Deely coal-fired plant. Despite finally closing its doors and CPS looking into other energy resources, groups like Climate Action San Antonio say their fight for cleaner air quality isn't over just yet. The Night Team's Sarah Acosta also spoke to one woman who lives near the plant about the impact of the closure on her personally.
It's a small win.
A small win for environmentalists that they say was slow going. The Deely coal-fired plant finally shut down in December after operating for more than 40 years. Just in 2017, Deely released 4.2 million metric tons of greenhouse gases according to the EPA's greenhouse gas report. But that's not the only facility on the Calaveras power plant on the southeast side. Climate Action San Antonio member Greg Harmon is now focused on closing the coal-fired Spruce plant on the same property.
Altogether, this complex is responsible for hundreds of thousands of pounds of toxic heavy metals.
The metals Harmon is referring to are these amounts of barium, lead, and mercury that came out of the Calaveras power plant as a whole in 2017, according to the EPA. CPS Energy CEO Paula Gold-Williams says they are aware of these emissions and are doing their best to protect the community while providing sufficient power. She says it's why they closed Deely.
We get that it's important to be protective from the environment.
The Spruce coal plant remains open because it meets current environmental standards that Deely did not.
We hear the community, and we have been on a path for many years to reduce our emissions, and we have done so, and we will continue to do that for the community as best we can.
It's also why Gold-Williams says the company is moving towards natural gas options. Harmon says CPS Energy should be putting its full focus on cleaner options like wind and solar energy.
When they talk about natural gas and the rest, is like they're really just putting off the real decision, which is how fast they're going to do something that is going to be carbon neutral. It's a false flag.
Melissa Enoch lives 4 miles south of the Calaveras power plant and says we are running out of time. Before moving to the area, she says she suffered from mercury poisoning, but believes the toxins that are released have prevented her from completely healing. She wants to make sure the children who live and play in the area are protected.
It's a selfish world we live in, full of greed, and nobody's looking after what the future is for the little ones. What are we going to leave them?
CPS Energy told us they are looking into wind and solar energies. However, because they are weather dependent, they also have to use other technologies in order to stay energy efficient. It is also invested in its STEP conservation program, which provides incentives to customers who reduce their energy use. The company told us as a whole, the city has decreased its energy since 2009. Steve?